स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ सर शशि हियर एंड वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी साइंस एंड इन साइंस वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी केमिस्ट्री पार्ट. ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी केमिस्ट्री पार्ट. सो वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू चैप्टर 4. सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट एलिमेंट. ओके, देन वी स्टडीड अबाउट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट दैट It was classified into 3 parts: metals, non-metals, and metalloids. All the 3 parts we had studied in our previous classes. Okay, now today we'll study the difference between metals and non-metals. So what are metals and non-metals? We are going to study the difference. Okay, although we have studied about metal and non-metal, so just difference we have to study. So already you know that metals are shiny, they shine, they are hard, they are not soft, they are hard. Malleable, that means they can be beaten into sheet, and ductile, that means they can be drawn into wires. Okay, whereas non-metals are dull. Look at here, it is shiny. Metals are shiny, whereas non-metals are dull. Non-lustrous means not shiny, and brittle in nature means if it is non-metal, then it will break into pieces. Okay, whereas if metal piece will be there, if you'll hit it, it will get flattened, isn't it? It will get become flat, it will not break into pieces. So it is not malleable. It does not show malleability and ductility, means we cannot draw into wires. Then second point, metals are sonorous. Sonorous means if any metal will fall on ground, then it will produce ringing sound. Okay, it will produce like your school bell. It is metal. If it will fall on the ground, it will produce ringing sound. If you'll hit it, it will produce ringing sound. But non-metals are not sonorous, like sulfur or coal. Coal is non-metal. If it will fall on ground, will it produce ringing sound? No, so it is not sonorous. Then metals, they are good conductors of heat and electricity, like copper, iron, sodium, etc. Means from these electricity can conduct. But from non-metals, they are not good conductors of heat and electricity, means heat and electricity cannot pass through non-metal, like sulfur, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. So these are your differences between metals and non-metals. Okay, now come to fill in the blanks. Taste yourself, fill in the blanks. So shiny, malleable and ductile elements are called. Shiny, malleable and ductile are called as what? Are called as metal. So this is your first answer. Then a non-metal present in liquid state is, non-metal present in liquid state is bromine. So the second answer is bromine. Okay, then third, a metal present in liquid state is mercury. What is that? Mercury. Then the fourth one, silicon is an example of metalloid. Okay, so all these 4 fill in the blanks you can do. Now come to question number 2. How many elements are known so far? How many elements? 118. When we were studying element, we came to know total 118 elements we know. Give the number of elements which are natural. Naturally, how many elements were there? 92 were found in nature. And how many elements are man-made? Rest out of 118, 92 are natural and rest are man-made. So this part you can do. Okay, now come to another part, compound. What is compound? Okay, so a substance that consists of 2 or more elements. combined together in definite proportion is called compound. So this is the definition of compound. What is compound? Any substance which are consist of two or more than two elements. So elements like oxygen is your element, carbon is your element, aluminium is your element, then sulfur is your element. Okay, so like this. So when two or more than two elements will combine in definite proportion, then it will be called as compound. Okay, so for example, hydrogen and oxygen combine to form water. When hydrogen and oxygen will combine, then hydrogen is one element, oxygen is other element. So two molecules of hydrogen and one molecule of oxygen, when it will combine, it will form what? It will form water, H2O. It is the chemical formula of water. Okay, then sugar is combination of carbon, oxygen and hydrogen. Look at here, three elements are there in sugar. Carbon is there, oxygen is there and hydrogen is there. Then in common salt is made up of sodium and chlorine. Okay, you can see here, common salt, sodium and chlorine, when they combine together, then they form salt. This is the salt. Okay, so salt is what? Salt is compound. Why it is compound? It is compound because chlorine and sodium both are combining together and it is forming what? It is forming common salt. So salt is compound. Why? Because it is made by combining two elements, sodium and chlorine. Okay, then you can see here, hydrogen and oxygen, when they both are combining together, then it is forming what? It is forming water. Then here, oxygen, hydrogen and carbon, when all these three are combining together, then they are forming what? They are forming sugar. So water is formed by what? Water is formed by hydrogen and oxygen. So water is formed by hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, hydrogen and oxygen combine together to form water. Then oxygen, hydrogen and carbon, when all these three elements combine together, they form what? They form sugar. Got it? So what is compound? What is compound? So substance that consists of two or more elements. Just now we have seen, when two or more elements are combining together in definite proportion, then it is called as compound. Okay, so compound, up to here you know. Okay, so today we'll do up to here. In the next class we'll continue further. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.